ultra-high-speed train, Canada to Mexico in one ride. Imagine a world where you can board a train in the icy wilderness of the Arctic, journey through bustling cities, and enjoy tacos in the vibrant heart of Mexico, all without stepping off the train. At first glance, this might sound like a scene from a sci-fi movie, but what if it could be real? A super train connecting all of North America could transform travel as we know it, zooming from the northernmost tip of Canada, through the United States, and straight to Mexico's southern edge in under 24 hours. So in this video, we will discuss the ultimate super train from Canada to Mexico in one ride. But before starting the video, be sure to smash the like button and subscribe to never miss out on any of our videos. The insane route. Let's map out what would undoubtedly be one of the most incredible journeys in the world. The adventure begins in alert Nunavut, Canada, a remote Arctic town where polar bears outnumber people and temperatures often dip below freezing. From this icy starting point, the train would head south to Toronto, a thriving metropolis known for its cultural diversity and iconic skyline. Imagine grabbing a quick coffee while admiring the CN Tower before boarding again for the next leg of the journey. In just 90 minutes, you find yourself in New York City, a city that never sleeps. From the bright lights of Times Square to the Statue of Liberty, there's no shortage of things to marvel at during a brief stop. After that, it's off to Chicago, the Windy City, with its deep-dish pizza and stunning architecture. The train then speeds westward to Denver, where you can catch a glimpse of the majestic Rocky Mountains before arriving in Los Angeles, where palm trees and sunshine await. But the journey doesn't stop there. Crossing the border into Mexico, the train heads to Mexico City, the vibrant capital known for its rich history, colorful streets, and of course, delicious tacos. After a quick culinary stop, the train races to its final destination, Tapachula, a city near the Guatemalan border. Covering a total distance of 8,000 miles, 13,000 kilometers, in under 24 hours, this route would connect people, cultures, and experiences in a way that's never been done before. The need for speed. To make this journey a reality, the train would need to travel faster than anything currently on land. So how can we achieve speeds that rival or even surpass airplanes? The key lies in revolutionary technology. First, we'd use maglev, magnetic levitation technology. By eliminating wheels and friction, the train would float above the tracks, gliding smoothly and efficiently at incredible speeds. Next, we incorporate hyperloop tubes. These vacuum-sealed tunnels drastically reduce air resistance, allowing the train to reach speeds of over 600 miles per hour, 1,000 kilometers slash a. Imagine traveling from the East Coast to the West Coast in under 5 hours. A feat that would be faster than most commercial flights. Lastly, the train would be powered by green energy. Solar panels, wind turbines, and hydrogen fuel cells would provide the necessary energy to keep the train eco-friendly and sustainable. By combining cutting-edge technology with renewable energy sources, this train wouldn't just be fast, it would also help combat climate change by reducing reliance on fossil fuels. Could this actually happen? As exciting as this idea sounds, it raises an important question. Could it actually happen? The first major challenge is cost. A project of this scale would likely require trillions of dollars in funding. Constructing thousands of miles of tracks, developing advanced technology, and maintaining such an ambitious network would be an enormous financial undertaking. However, history has shown that large infrastructure projects like the Hoover Dam or the Apollo program can yield transformative benefits. The second challenge is politics. For this project to succeed, Canada, the United States, and Mexico would need to work together seamlessly. Coordinating between three different governments, each with its own priorities and policies, would be a significant hurdle. Nevertheless, the potential benefits of such collaboration, enhanced trade, tourism, and cultural exchange, could incentivize cooperation. The third challenge is geography. North America is a continent of extremes, with vast mountain ranges, arid deserts, and frozen tundras. Building a high-speed rail system across such diverse and challenging terrain would require groundbreaking engineering solutions. Tunnels through mountains, bridges over canyons, and tracks designed to withstand harsh weather conditions would all be necessary. Despite these challenges, there's hope. Countries like China, Japan, and several in Europe have already demonstrated the feasibility of high-speed rail systems. With the right investment and political will, there's no reason why North America can't join the ranks of leaders in rail innovation. Closing and call to action. So here's the big question. Would you ride this ultimate super train? Imagine the convenience, the speed, and the unique opportunity to experience the diverse cultures of North America in a single journey. It's a vision of the future that's as thrilling as it is ambitious. If you're excited about this idea, smash that like button, drop a comment to share your thoughts, and let us know if you think this could be a future of travel. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos exploring futuristic ideas and innovations, because the future isn't just coming, it's speeding toward us. Thank you guys for watching. If you want more videos like this, make sure to like the video and hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you in the next video.
Copyright disclaimer under Section 107 of the Copyright Act 1976. Allowance is made for fair use for purposes such as criticism, comment, news reporting, scholarship, and research. Fair use is a use permitted by copyright statute that might otherwise be infringing. Nonprofit, educational, or personal use tips the balance in favor of fair use.